Now, we're going to say a gamma particle can be represented by 0 over 0, and the gamma symbol is this. Now, you're going to say because it's 0 over 0, you should realize that a gamma ray actually does not cause any change in your atomic mass or atomic number. And because of that, we usually see it happening with alpha decay or beta decay. But what's the whole purpose of gamma emission then? Well, we're going to say when it comes to gamma emission, it has to do with the absorption of energy. So here we're going to say this wavy line represents energy. And this electron is in our first shell in our atom. So here in absorption, the electron's going to absorb that excess energy and become excited and use that extra energy it just absorbed to jump up to either a higher shell number or to a higher orbital number. So basically, if you go from 1s to 2s, so you're going from the first shell to the second shell, that represents absorption. You could also go from the 3s to 3d. You can skip 3p altogether and just jump up straight to 3d. Both of these examples represent absorption. The first one represents absorption when you jump from one shell to a higher shell. And then the 3s to the 3d represents you absorbing energy and jumping up from a lower orbital to a higher orbital within the same shell. Both of them begin with the number 3, so they're both within the third shell of your atom. But d orbitals have more energy than s orbitals. So if we saw this, we'd have 40 over 20 calcium. It undergoes a gamma emission. And we'd say that that calcium has an electron that had just absorbed energy, and it's going to become excited. So we put a little asterisk by it to show that it's in an excited state. So that would represent a gamma emission. Now, we're going to say that gamma particles, they have the lowest ionizing power, but they have the highest penetrating power. So if you're ever exposed to gamma emission, like gamma radiation, it's basically a done deal. You're not going to survive. Gamma radiation is extremely toxic to living tissue and biological systems. So any exposure to even a smallest amount of gamma radiation would completely eviscerate all the living cells and tissues within your body. So it has the lowest ionizing power, but it's still extremely dangerous.